Hi guys, it's Peter and welcome to our channel. Today I'm going to talk about Sega Game Gear and I'd like to show you my modded Sega Game Gear. I just finished it a couple weeks ago. Run it for quite some time and then remodel it again. Anyway, let me introduce you my Sega Game Gear Dream Machine, and here it is. Oh, I'm sorry, that's not it. That's another project, which didn't finish yet. Actually, it's right here, so sorry about that, guys. And on the first glance, it looks almost identical to a stock version. But, of course, like I just mentioned, I did some modification. And basically, I did install it McWheel screen. It's a TFT 3.5 backlit screen, which is really, really nice. There's no any comparison with original one. This is a really jaw dropper. I mean, the quality wise, it's like day and night compared to original one. I mean, I really love it. It's well worth it. If you guys planning to modify your Game Gear with McWheel screen, 100% I do recommend it. I mean, go for it. Like I said, the quality of wise of a picture looks really nice. I'm sorry about that reflection. I mean, it's super, super nice, clean, bright picture. A few things which I'd like to mention it. It's kind of... I'm not saying I was disappointed when I discovered that, but I was kind of surprised and not in a good way. First of all, when you converted the brightness, but I mean the knob, it doesn't work the way you actually expected, like it was working on a original model. The brightness will not work at all. I mean, if you plug it in, there's the one wire comes to plug it to that dial and to control it video out. Pretty much, if you plug it to external VGA monitor, then you turn it your dial all the way down, the screen will turn off. I disconnect that. Even I didn't install it yet VGA connector, because the one come in a box, standard VGA connector, that's a joke. I see a lot of people put it right here, but come on, it's a big and bulky jack. I mean that a connector. It's not acceptable in my opinion. If I find it something smaller, I mean like maybe micro. I believe they do make a micro VGA and place it probably right here somewhere, which is gonna be kind of a really tiny connector, really concealed. It's one thing, but that big one, there's no way I'm installing. Like I said, that's a joke. Then also, like I said, I mean, the screen is really nice, but when you place it, when you going to convert your Sega Game Gear, it's pretty much straightforward. You just follow the instruction step by step and you will make it through no problem. In my opinion, that mod, it's not super hard. I should call probably required a medium skills or so and you can do it. I mean, you don't have to be rocket scientist, like I was saying. But there's a few things where I'd like to mention it. It should be designed from beginning slightly different. Let me show you my old board from another Game Gear. And you can, when you look at it like that, you probably do recognize it, how screen sticks out, probably up to 4 millimeters. When you place it McWheel module into the board, it slides, it's kind of like sandwich style, it slides right in that screen and the back control board, it will slide. The main board will slide between them. Pretty much, there's no way you can bring it in and out. And it sits quite shallow. Basically, original seal, the one is meant to be like that, for example, and prevent all, the dust come in and out. The original seal will not do any trick, because the gap between screen and the bezel, it's gonna be around 3 millimeter gap. And that pretty much, that's why I'm saying I did, when I modified, I really like it, but then I did have to remodify it, because in the first week, I recognized a particle of dust start getting in the screen. And that's, I mean, mostly, probably some people will not complain about that, but my case is different. I'm quite picky. I always want to, when I do modification, I always want to be, works the way it's supposed to be, kind of like perfect style almost. And when I see the dust, I said, I have to do something. And basically what I did, it's kind of simple mat after all. I'm using a construction, double stick foam tape. This one is like around 4 millimeter. And here in the picture, you can see I did edit around the bezel. That foam tape, you can squeeze it to probably to 2 millimeter. And the maximum can go is as thick as the original, seal. But this tape, foamy tape, will prevent any debris, any dust getting in your screen. And let me turn it off my system. Like I said, it's probably modified, I should say maybe a month or so. And when you look at the screen, I hope you guys can see it, there's no dust at all. I mean, usually when it's dust, when you turn it off screen, you will see it. And now, I mean, it's like I said, almost a month later, I'm playing it quite often, the system. I really enjoy it, and there's no dust at all. Then one more I added to this mat, because if you installing a new LCD screen on your used Sega Game Gear, it doesn't matter how good condition was from beginning, the plastic lens will have bunch scratches. And then it's kind of, I mean, when you look at it right now, you can see there's a bunch dust between glass, and plus a lot of scratches. Like I said, the dust issue eliminate by adding that foam tape. Scratches, of course, you can put it a new plastic lens, or like I did, I installed it glass, true real glass lens. I mean, if you look at it, doesn't have that concave, I mean, that bowl shape like original one do. I mean, if you compare it side by side, it's okay. I mean, to me, I don't see any different, but the real glass, let me tap it. You can hear it. It's real. Real glass. It's, I don't know how many times, 100 times more stronger than plastic, of course, scratch resistant. And plastic lens will attract more dust. It's like a magnet dust. I mean, magnet for dust. Glass lens is different. It doesn't build electrostatic. I mean, it's much better. And like I said, it's gonna stay much longer without any scratches. Like I said, that's kind of a simple modification, in my opinion. I mean, straightforward. Also, when I added screen, I mean, I added glass. Then when you flip it upside down or like backside, when you do that mat, there's not going to be that screw involved, because you have to trim it, cut it, that post. I did edit the post, I mean, that piece what I busted, cut it off shorter, glue it back, and put it original screw. Of course, the original screw, I have to trim it as well. But I did that just to make it looks like that system was never been modded. I mean, if you look it from behind, because like I said, the first hinge, what it give you idea, the system being modded, the screw will not be there, because there's not gonna be any post. Otherwise, I am so happy how it works. Well, guys, this mat, like I said before, I do recommend it. It's well worth it. I mean, especially if you really like your Game Gear, you got pretty good library, like I do, probably close to 100 games or so, and I always enjoy the Game Gear. I always like the system. A new TFT backlit screen, that's like you bring a new life to your Game Gear. Well, guys, I hope this video was useful, enjoyable. If you do enjoy it, thumbs up. If you don't want to miss any future videos, subscribe. We will be really appreciate it.